Good day, everyone. Our subject for today is technology and livelihood education, TLE6, and we are still on information and communication technology, or ICT and entrepreneurship. Our topic is creating an online survey form and processing online survey data. Our most essential learning competencies: creates an online survey form. Our code TLE IE6-0E-9 processes online survey data. Our code TLE IE6-0E-11. This video lesson will help you to define online survey, identify the online survey tools, give the advantages and disadvantages of using online survey, and discuss the steps in creating and processing a survey using Google Forms. Definition of online survey. Online survey is an innovative, easier, and faster way to deliver surveys, collect results, and analyze the results using online system. This tool is used to define questions and the possible answers using the internet. The link to these survey questions are then sent to the participants who will answer the survey online. In business, this tool is utilized to determine any of the following: feedback for products and services, employee satisfaction, customer feedback, market research. We have some online survey tools. Online survey tools are easy to make. You can even choose between free and paid plans. For light audience research, you may use the following free online survey tools. First, SurveyMonkey. SurveyMonkey is the most popular online survey tool and is very easy to use. Its free version includes 10 questions, 100 respondents, 15 question types, and choice of light theme. Second, SurveyGizmo. SurveyGizmo is a great free survey platform, even with its free version. Here are free version features: it's unlimited survey questions, free templates, and basic reporting. Third, we have Google Forms. Google Forms is an online survey tool that provides a fast way to get information for meetings and conferences. Google Forms features unlimited survey and respondents. It allows answers and data to be automatically collected in Google's spreadsheets. Images and pages can also be added. The survey may be embedded into emails or websites. We have advantages of using online survey. First, online survey is cheaper. There is no need for printing the questionnaires or to worry about the other expenses in collecting data. Collecting data is faster. Respondents can easily access online surveys. Information and answers from the respondents can also be collected automatically. Thus, the results may be analyzed anytime. Third, it is more convenient for respondents. Respondents can access the survey anywhere they are available and anytime that suits their schedule. Fourth, it is easy to use for researchers. Researchers can collect responses instantly. The collected data can also be easily transferred to various applications. We have disadvantages of online survey. First, technical problems may be encountered. The server may crash, unstable internet connection, and technical variants in browsers and computers are just some technical issues that respondents and researchers may face using online surveys. Second, respondents may not fully cooperate. Some respondents may ignore some questions or the whole survey. Third, there is no interviewer. The researcher has no control over the respondents. There will be no one to explain the survey and ask follow-up questions that may lead to less reliable results. creating and processing a survey using Google Forms. To create an online survey using Google Forms, you must have the following: Google account, Chrome web browser, Google Forms web application. We have these tips in creating and processing a survey using Google Forms. First, log into your Google account. Click on the Forms web application icon. The Forms icon will appear when you add a new tab. So you can click the blank template. Okay, so we have there the blank template. And third, a complete survey setup. Write a title for your survey. Okay, so we have there a sample is grade 6 online survey. Fourth, add and edit questions. So we have to add questions and edit. Fifth, edit the survey completion confirmation. Customize the text that respondents will see after completing the survey. To do this, click on the More Actions drop-down menu found in the upper right corner, then select Edit Confirmation. Be sure to thank respondents for participating. Number 6, distribute the survey. Click Email this form to distribute the survey. 7, view responses. Gather survey responses in a spreadsheet, save to your Google Drive. Open the spreadsheet to view the responses. Number 8, edit the survey later. If you need to edit the Google Form later, open the spreadsheet from your Google Drive on the Form menu item and choose Edit Form. This will return you to the original screen used to create the survey. We have here a sample survey form. So, customer satisfaction survey. Okay, so ituturo ko ngayon kung paano gumawa ng online survey using Google Forms. Okay, so punta tayo sa ating web browser, Google Chrome, double click. At gawa tayo ng new tab. So, click natin. And then, sign in tayo sa ating Gmail account. So, gamitin natin ang account na ito. Then, next. Okay, so, naka-sign in na tayo. So, makikita natin yung 9 dots. So, click natin Google Apps. At hanapin natin yung icon ng Google Forms. Okay, ito. So, click. So, meron na tayong Google Forms. Dito na tayo. So, meron dito mga templates na pwede natin gamitin. So, gawa tayo. Start a new form. So, click this blank. Okay, so, meron na tayong untitled survey form. Okay, so, pwede natin lagyan ng title. Okay, halimbawa, Grade 6 online survey. Pwede rin tayo maglagay ng description. So, halimbawa, lagyan natin online survey for TLE subject school year, so 2020 to 2021. So, meron na tayong title, meron na tayong description ng ating, no? So, yung responses, no? So, mamaya babalikan natin ito. Dito sa tabi ay mayroong mga commands, no? So, pag clinic natin ito, so add question. So, magdadagdag tayo ng tanong. Ito ay import questions. Halimbawa, meron ng tayong prepared questions, pwede na natin import natin. Dito naman, add title or description. So, pwede tayo. Dito, pwede tayo mag-add image. So, magdagdag ng image dito sa ating survey form. Pwede rin tayo mag-add ng video. Magdagdag, maglagay ng video. At mag-add section. Okay? So, babalikan natin ito. Gawa muna tayo ng question. Halimbawa, add question. Yung first question natin ay dito ay nakalagay multiple choice. So, mayroong arrow down dito. Pag clinic natin, may mga type of questions na pwede natin gamitin. So, short answer. Okay? So, mga tanong na nangangailangan lang ng maikling sagot. Okay? Paragraph. yung mga tanong na kailangan ng mahabang sagot, paragraph form, multiple choice yung pagpipilian nila ang mga sagot or options. So check boxes, drop down, linear scale, multiple choice grid, check box grid, no? So dito halimbawa yung pagpipilian nila ay lima. Halimbawa 1 to 5 is a scale of 1 to 5. Halimbawa yung 1 is strongly agree. Tapos yung 3 halimbawa ay agree, at yung 5 halimbawa strongly disagree. So pagka mayroon tayong mga tanong na pwede natin gamitin itong linear scale. So punta, gamitin muna natin yung click yung short answer. So yung question halimbawa o yung data na kailangan natin ay kailangan natin ng pangalan ng respondents. So lagyan natin pangalan. Pwede natin gawing optional, no? Pwede natin gamitin optional. Ibig sabihin pwede isulat, pwede hindi yung pangalan ng respondent. Pagka ganun, hindi na natin kailangan i-require ito. So since trial version natin ito ay sinusubukan natin, so i-require natin sila ilagay ang kompletong pangalan nila. So complete name. Okay? So since na-require natin, so i-click natin yung required. Yeah, required. So kailangan nila maglagay ng pangalan nila. Okay? So dagdagan natin ng tanong o nung data na kailangan pa natin. So click again, add question. So kailangan natin halimbawa yung gender, no? Yung gender ng respondents. So click natin gender. So multiple choice gamitin natin dito yung halimbawa yung checkbox. Okay, so dito ay sulat natin ay male. So click natin yung dalawa lang naman, no? Male, female. So automatic enter natin, lalabas na yung female. So mayroon na tayong data na dalawa ang kailangan sa survey natin, yung pangalan ng respondent tsaka yung kasarian o gender. Okay, so magdagdag pa tayo ng isang tanong. Okay, so gender, halimbawa yung tanong natin is what is your favorite subject. Ayan, ito yung paborito mong subject. So ilalagay natin yung mga subjects dito. So gamitin natin yung check boxes pa rin. So i-check natin nila ng respondents kung ano ang favorite subject nila. So lagay natin ang mga subjects natin ay halimbawa ay Philippine. Next subject natin halimbawa ay English. Next subject natin is science. Next subject natin is math, mathematics. So yung next subject natin halimbawa ay TLE or Technology and Livelihood Education. Okay? So enter. Next subject natin is EP or Araling Panlipunan. Tapos next subject natin sa halimbawa is MAPE or Music, Arts, Physical Education and Health. At ang sa pang subject natin ay ESP or Edukasyon sa Pagpapakatao. So 8 subjects tayo, pipili sila kung ano ang favorite subject nila dito. So i-click nila dyan, may box. So ayan, halimbawa ito lang muna yung tatlong questions natin o data na kailangan natin. Halimbawa pwede tayo magdagdag maya. Okay, so dito responses, makikita natin kung anong mga response, ilan ang responses na natin. So punta tayo dito sa customize theme. Okay, so click natin ito, mayroon tayong theme options. So header, pwede tayo maglagay ng image. Okay, halimbawa click natin ito, image natin. So mayroon mga themes na pagpipilian dito, work and school. So itong mga headers ay pwede tayo pumili dito. Halimbawa ay sa sports, so mayroon din mga themes na pwedeng gamitin. So balik tayo sa work and school at pumili tayo ng header na gagamitin natin. So halimbawa ito, click pag-clinic natin ito. So click insert. Ayan, insert. So ina-upload, image uploaded. So andyan na, mayroon na tayong header, mayroon tayong title ng survey, may description, at mayroon na rin tayong ilang questions. So theme, no? So pwede natin theme color, pwede natin palitan. So may background color, pwede rin tayong magpalit. So depende sa gusto natin o sa ano natin. Okay, so font style, may basic yung font. So mayroon din drop arrow dito,
pagbibilian. Okay? So, basic muna. Basic ang font style na gamitin natin. Okay? So, close natin. At, halimbawa, gusto natin tingnan yung maging itsura nito. Yung final na itsura ng ating survey form. Click natin itong preview button. Okay? Preview. Ayan. So, ito, may header tayo. So, ito, nakalagay required. So, merong asterisk dito, ibig sabihin na kailangan ilagay yung pangalan, kompletong pangalan ng respondents. Gender. Pag natapos sila, click nila yung submit, ayun, sa mapapabilang na sila doon sa mga respondents. Okay? So, dito naman mayroong settings. Click natin ito sa kung anong settings. Pwede natin maglagay. Okay? So, depende sa atin. So, yeah, okay. So, restrict to users in Department of Education. Presentation. Okay? So, pwede rin. Yung confirmation message, automatic, your response has been recorded. So, pwede natin lagyan. No? Your response has been recorded. Thank you for your cooperation. No? For answering our survey. So, hindi na natin muna babaguhin. So, yung default confirmation message, your response has been recorded. Pag okay na, save. No? So, cancel muna natin for the meantime. So, pag natapos na yan, pwede natin send. No? Send natin yung ating survey form. So, send form via email. No? Ito, automatic email. So, itatype natin yung email address ng padadala natin ng survey. Okay? Tapos, pwede rin natin send via link. Ito yung link ng ating survey form. So, pwede natin kopyahin at ilagay natin, copy-paste natin doon sa halimbawa sa Facebook o sa ating GC, halimbawa, para doon nila i-click ang link at makakasagot na sila sa ating online survey. Okay? So pwede natin i-share form via Facebook. Pwede din natin share form via Twitter. Close muna natin ito for the meantime. Okay? So itong responses, pag-click natin, dito makikita, sabi ko, kung ilan ang sumagot sa ating online survey. Okay? So, makikita natin. So, mayroon tayo dito makikita na positive sign. So, create spreadsheet. No? Click natin ito. So, create a new spreadsheet. Then, create. Click create. So, dito, lahat ng data ng ating survey dito ay makikita. At pwede natin ma-process yung data natin using Microsoft Excel. No? Dito sa ano, mayroon tayong functions. So, mayroong drop-down arrow. Pag-click natin ito, makikita natin yung mga operations na pwede natin magamit, process natin yung ating data. Okay? So, mayroon dito, scroll down lang natin. So, financial, filter, math, statistical. So, click natin, libawa, statistical. So, dito sa tabi, ay mayroon dito mga statistical tools na pwede natin gamitin. Pipili na lang natin tayo. So, mapra-process yung data natin using these statistical tools. Okay? Ayan. Okay? So, kung halimbawa gusto natin balikan yung ating online survey form, i-edit natin, dagdagan natin ng question. So, click lang natin itong form. No? Click form. Meron dati yung edit form. Yan, edit form. So, andito tayo. Bumalik sa original nating online survey form. Okay? So, halimbawa, gusto natin dagdagan ng tanong. Okay? So, click lang natin ito. Ayan. So, add question. Pwede tayo magdagdag ng question. No? So, bahala na kayo kung anong question. So, pag-click natin ito, so, andyan, mamili lang ulit tayo kung anong short answer, paragraph, multiple choice, questions, check boxes, drop down, linear grid. Okay? Ganun lang ang ating paggawa ng online survey para sa subject natin.
Now let's do together. In groups, use Google Forms to create an online survey about any topic. Present output in class. Okay, so you will be divided into groups and each group will create an online survey using Google Forms and then you will present your output in the class. Then evaluate your online survey using the following rubrics. So our rubrics have criteria. First, content. Second, analysis. Organization. So you have the score. 4 is the highest and 1 lowest. Disclaimer. This presentation was made for educational purposes only. No copyright infringement intended. Text, images, and clips. All rights credited to the owner. Thank you and God bless us all.